Why your computer might be slow. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Some time ago, a friend came to me with a scenario where his computer had suddenly gotten quite slow. What I want to do in this video and the companion article on which this video is based is walk you through some of the big components that contribute to computer slowness, because they are the steps that I walked through to try and identify exactly what had happened to my friend's machine, and hopefully provide you a little bit of structure that allows you to diagnose on your own, perhaps some of the causes of slowness on your own machine. Now, the scenario that my friend had was that on his Windows 10 machines, it had become, I'll just call it, almost unbearably slow. He'd called earlier indicating that there had been a problem, and he'd clicked some kind of a pop-up message to call this number that could not be dismissed, followed by a misclick of some sort of Microsoft Edge, at which point the disk light started flickering continuously and his system came to a crawl. Now, there's a fair amount of data in that description, and the best way I decided to examine what was going on in his system was to walk through what I consider to be the big four, the four big components of computer speed. Some of them you'll recognize, some of them might surprise you, but they're all things that are within your grasp to at least be able to take a look at and diagnose and see if maybe they're contributing to your problem. We'll see exactly what it was in my friend's case by the time we get to the end. There are four basic components to computer speed: the speed of your CPU, the speed of your disk, the speed of your internet, and the amount of RAM you have in your system. Let's look at each one of those in sequence. CPU is what everybody looks at or thinks of almost immediately. Their computer is slow, therefore the CPU must be overworked. Sometimes it is. Sometimes the CPU is so busy working on something that it doesn't have time for something else. And that something else might even be responding to the keyboard or displaying something on the screen. Your computer might be working so hard performing a calculation that it just doesn't have any time left over. The best way to understand if this is the problem is to fire up Task Manager. And if you fire up Task Manager, you will be able to see exactly what percentage of your CPU is in use. Now, this example on the screen is a screenshot of Task Manager I made of a system that's running okay. And you'll see that the CPU is 0% used, which means that it's doing nothing. It's idling. It's twiddling its thumbs. If we were to take a look at another display or another way that we can examine CPU usage, it might show us that the system idle process is 99% of the CPU, is where the CPU is spending 99% of its time. That's okay. The CPU is not the cause of your problem here. On the other hand, you can click on the header. You can click on the phrase or the word CPU at the top of that column, and it'll sort that column by the CPU usage with the most CPU usage at the top. If it doesn't give you the most at the top, click on that header again to reverse the sort order. But one way or another, you will eventually get the program that is running the most, that is using the most CPU, displayed at the top of the list. That could explain your problem. If you suddenly find that, I don't know, Excel is at the top of the list, then it may be that Excel is performing a calculation and using most of your CPU. If you're running a video encoding software, as I do from time to time, you may find that the encoder is using most of the CPU and it's behind whatever is causing your system to be slow. And eventually, when it completes its work, your system will return to normal. That's how you find out if it's a CPU-based problem. Disk. This is, as I like to call it, the storage that sticks around. This is where your software writes information that is kept across your system being shut down and turned back on again. It's where your files are stored. It's where your documents are stored. It's where Windows itself is stored. There are a number of things that can cause disk usage to go way up. The one I'm going to focus on first is simply an application that is doing a lot of disk writing. It might be that your video encoder or your spreadsheet or whatever other software you're running is doing something that is very, very disk intensive. Now, your disk is going to be slower than your CPU, which means then that most of the time, if your computer is spending most of its time reading and writing to disk, the rest of the time, it's just going to be waiting. It's going to be waiting for the disk operation to finish. But if one of the things you're also trying to do is also writing to that disk, say that you are saving a document while your video encoder is encoding a video and using the disk heavily, then yeah, it's going to seem like your system is slow because it's going to take a long time for your document to be written, longer perhaps than normal because all of this other disk activity is going on. Once again, we return to Task Manager and we can again click on the column header for the disk column, and that will show you in megabytes per second who's writing to the disk. Now, it won't necessarily tell you if this is the cause for your slowdown, but if while you are experiencing a slowdown, you come back to this and it's consistently one program or another, that will tell you something. That may tell you that it's that program that is responsible for the slowness you're experiencing. In the example screen capture I've got right here, you'll see it's anti-malware service executable. That's super, super common. When you first fire up your machine or when you download something for the first time, you may encounter Windows Defender scanning your system for malware in the files that you just downloaded or in your system. That can cause the disk to be used very heavily. Similarly, the content indexing service can also cause your system to slow down unexpectedly. Now, a third reason for perceived slowness is your internet connection. A lot of times what people consider to be a slow machine is really nothing more than in some ways their own impatience. The fact is, it doesn't really matter how fast your computer is, CPU, disk, RAM, or anything, if it's all just waiting for data to come down your internet connection. If you've got a slow connection to the internet and what you're doing is primarily online, then it can seem slow. But there's nothing about your machine involved. It's simply the speed at which the data is able to be transferred across the wire from the internet to you. Now, that seems fairly simple. If you've got a slow internet connection, then yeah, internet activity is going to be slow. But what if you've got a fast internet connection and it's still slow? Well, one of the things to realize is that the internet connection to your home is shared with all the devices that happen to use the internet. Now, in years past, that may have been just a couple of computers, and you've kind of got a sense for what's happening on each of those machines. But on the other hand, especially now, with so many Internet of Things devices and mobile phones that use Wi-Fi and all these other devices in our homes, in my home, I've got something like 30 or 35 different devices all connected to the internet at the same time. If any one of those or a couple of those start to do something online, something big online, like a large download or an update, then yeah, that can impact the speed or the perceived speed of the internet connection on all the other devices. In other words, on your device. So that's something to at least consider. Going back to Task Manager, we can at least have a look to see if there is one specific program on your machine that happens to be using a lot of the internet right now. Same thing, in Task Manager, click on the network column heading and you can sort by the amount of data that's being transferred across the internet, across the network for the application involved. When I see this, the example I've got here shows nobody using the internet. In reality, they're using it a very tiny, tiny bit. When I see high network usage, in my case, it's usually Dropbox. It's usually one of the cloud service providers synchronizing files that either I've updated that are being uploaded or that somebody else has updated and is being downloaded to my system. Those are common reasons for high internet usage that you may not be directly responsible for yourself by the application you happen to be running. Now, another one, this one that actually manifests more as a disk speed issue, but in reality, it's the amount of RAM you have in your system. So Windows tries really hard. It does. It tries really hard to make things work even when you try to exceed its capacity. By that, I mean if you run enough software that wants to use more RAM than you actually have, Windows uses what's called virtual memory. That is memory that is written to disk or read from disk as needed to make room for all these other requests. Depending on what you're doing, if you're doing a lot of things that require a lot of RAM, that can slow down your system because all of that writing to or reading from your hard disk, also known as paging, can really slow down your system. Your system, the software you're running, is used to working with RAM, and as far as it's concerned, it still is working with real RAM that's very fast. But under the hood, the system is having to compensate for the lack of RAM by reading and writing things to disk. Now, one of the ways to look at this is, again, in Task Manager, sort by the memory column and see how much RAM is being used by your system, by the software on your system. If you find that it aggregates to more of the RAM than you actually have on your system, or if you find that there's one application that's using an excessive amount of RAM at that particular time, that might give you a clue as to what is or isn't actually causing the system to slow down. But again, this typically will manifest as a disk issue. You'll probably see the disk light flashing more or less continuously if you have one of those. And yet it may not be disk activity on your part. It may be the system compensating for a lack of RAM. So what happened to my friend? Because I went through all of these steps and it was inconclusive. There was nothing that really stuck out. Now, I never did see the pop-up that he described that had this call this number. It's a typical scam, never call the number, by the way. But I wasn't sure exactly what it was he saw. Now, normally, he uses Chrome. And in his frustration with the error message, he clicked on Edge. So I clicked on Edge. Edge started and started again and again and again and again. Within a few minutes, the taskbar was filling up with more and more instances of Edge. Now, each copy of Edge uses a little bit more RAM until eventually you're using more RAM than you actually have. The system started thrashing. It started paging like crazy. It slowed to a crawl because too many copies of Edge were running. It's like running too much software. Too much RAM was being requested of the system. It was swapping things to and from disk. It was getting more and more requests. It was reading and writing more and more to disks. It just slowed to a crawl. We had our culprit. It was RAM related, and it was because Edge had gotten itself into this loop of starting over and over and over again. The fix was to basically kill all those instances of Edge so that I could finally get to one. And what I ended up doing was resetting the home page setting for Edge. This is an older version of Edge prior to the Chromium update. But the issue here was simply that something had corrupted the home page setting for Edge. It could have been malware. It could have been something else. We really don't know. But actually changing Edge to go to a known start page rather than whatever the heck it was doing stopped it from trying to start over and over and over again. What's interesting about this scenario is that it came to light because of a misclick on this message that came up. It's very likely that Edge had been broken for a long time, certainly before this particular scenario happened. Since he never used Edge, he never encountered the problem. It was only this misclick that he happened to click on Edge that caused that to come to light. And because that happened at the same time as this other scare message, it seemed like they were related when in fact they weren't. That's my hypothesis anyway. That's just a guess. There's no way to know for real exactly what happened in hindsight. The real takeaway here is that when your system slows down, There are a number of things to look at. Hopefully, you can do so now with a little bit of methodology. CPU, then disk, then internet, then RAM, and sort of see what it is that's using resources on your system. Sometimes, not always, but sometimes, a culprit will become very clear. When that happens, that'll give you the clue you need to do whatever it is that needs to be done, be it stop running the software, or try not to use the internet everybody at the same time, or stop Edge from starting over and over again, whatever, you may end up with a clue that will allow you to resolve the problem. Even if you can't resolve the problem, that clue can then provide valuable data as the diagnosis proceeds to help you understand exactly why the system is slowing down. I hope that helps. I hope that gives you some direction. For updates, for related links, for comments and more, visit askleo.com/29551. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.